Hello beauties and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a little bit different than my regular skincare tips and skincare routines or ingredients or service. This video is going to be for those that are interested or considering becoming an esthetician. So I do have a couple of clients that have mentioned to me, oh, if I could ever do anything, I would become an esthetician. Or I have a client that's considering becoming an esthetician while she goes through her medical school or something around those lines. So that's where I got the inspiration to make this video, to answer some of the common questions about becoming an esthetician and what it is like. So an esthetician usually treats the skin, the top layers of the skin, the top layer of the skin, and some of the services include facials, waxing, chemical peels, microdermabrasion, and a lot of the more modern treatments, dermaplaning. Depending on the state, each state is different, so it varies from state to state on what an esthetician can and cannot do, but the most common is always going to be facials, waxing. Some estheticians will also do body treatments or lashes, and like I said, some states it varies whether you have to be an esthetician or not. Also, makeup application. I am originally from Florida, and when I first became an esthetician, I actually wanted to do makeup. And in the state of Florida, you need to be an esthetician to touch someone's skin. A lot of people don't follow those rules or those regulations, but it is required in the state of Florida, or at least it was required 10 years ago when I became an esthetician. Schooling also varies from state to state. Each state requires a certain amount of hours for you to complete before you could become an esthetician. Some states require 300 hours, and then some states will require 1,000 or 1,200 hours. So it all depends on your state how long the school is going to be, and the price for the school usually varies also, depending on the type of school that you go to. There are some a well-known recognized name, and then there's your local mom and pop or smaller one location school, and those are going to sometimes be a little bit more affordable. There's a financial aid available in most cases depending on the price. But you would have to contact the financial ed rep in that school to get full information. I'm not that informed on every state. And they usually vary from 3,000. I have heard like it usually goes along with the hours. So if it's like a 300 hour course, it could be $3,000. If it's a 12,000 hour course, it usually is about 12,000-15,000, depending on, or more depending on, the school and how much or how long the program is. Another question that I get asked is, what is the difference between cosmetology and esthetician? So as a cosmetologist, you are actually able to practice hair, I believe nails, and skincare. The only thing that it would exclude would be massage. Most states require a separate license for massage. But the information covered in most cosmetology schools is very limited. In cosmetology school, most programs only cover about a week of skincare. For me, that would just be very basic and I would not know what to do, but there's always the option to continue your education outside, which you're usually going to have to anyways, because schools are more basic skin conditions and extractions, massage. And whenever you really want to understand a skin condition and what you need to do to help it or to heal it or to help the balance, the skin get back into balance, you usually need to really understand the product that you're working with and the conditions. So it is an option if you are already a cosmetologist and you want to continue to skincare, you could always continue your education in it. Like I said, it does vary from state to state, so you want to check with your state board for anything that I say. You're going to want to check for your state board to see how much your license will cover. I received my training in Florida and I moved to Texas, and now I practice in Texas. I know that the requirements in Texas are different. I was grandfathered in because I was already practicing for 4 years, so they took the amount of hours that I had completed in Florida plus my experience, and I was able to get my license in Texas without additional training or additional hours, just taking the state law exam. But if I had not been practicing for a long time and I had taken my license in Florida and then tried to move here right away, I was going to have to go back to school and continue my education. So that's something that you want to keep in mind too. Once you become an esthetician and you want to move to a different state, each state is going to be different, so you might want to look into that state before you make the move. So what job opportunities can you expect after going to esthetician school? The possibilities for skincare or estheticians, it's actually pretty wide. You could work from a department stores like your Clinique counters or any of those counters. Sometimes not all of them are estheticians, but some of them are. You could also work in a school. You could continue your education and become an instructor and teach at a school, or you could work for a professional line as a distributor, or you could work as an actual esthetician at a spa. Some dermatologists will take estheticians too if they provide those services. And there's also, you know, salons that provide facial treatments and hair treatments, spa. So there's so many options. There's also the medical spa. I've covered everything that I could think of right now. If there's anything that you do that I didn't mention, if you're already an esthetician or if you're already considering and you have done the research, make sure that you comment below so that whoever finds this video could also check out the comments. So what is the income potential? I know that if you want to be an esthetician, you probably are wondering, how much do we make? How much can you make? Can I make a living from this? Can I really continue or pursue this? At the beginning, I do want to say that it could be on the lower end, and you could always work your way up depending on your experience and your amount of licensing that you have. You could always get additional licenses, like for lashes or laser or specific training. So that's gonna also open up new avenues for you, and you could always ask for more, the more that you could provide to a certain company. So at the beginning, you might be hired as low as minimum wage just during training, and during that time, it is possible that you could be hired at that low. But for the most part, from what I hear from other estheticians and what I have experienced, the regular range would be around $10 an hour if you work for someone. If you're working at a medical spa and you have additional licenses like laser, then you might be getting paid more for being an esthetician and a laser tech. Some of the department stores do pay more. So I will tell you my story in a minute, but I have gone through so many different jobs that I have worked, from a counter to a med spa, and I have been interviewed by different places, and each pay is different. There's places that are going to pay you strictly hourly, and obviously your tips, and there's places that will pay you hourly plus commission if you sell products, and there's so many pay options. I am a dual licensed esthetician and massage therapist, so I have been paid in so many different ways. My massage is usually paid completely different than my esthetician. It usually does pay a little bit more as a massage therapist, just if you're considering both of those careers. So So the pay could be anywhere from minimum wage to about 15 to 17, depending on the state. It could be more, I have heard, in the 20s. So you could make a decent, more than minimum wage salary as an esthetician. There's also the option of going on your own, which you would keep the profits to yourself, which is what I do now. I'm a solo esthetician. I do have expenses though, so I don't keep everything to myself. And then there's also the option of eventually owning your own salon, which you will hire other estheticians. So there is room for growth in the industry, in the esthetician world. So you could go from, if you want something on the safer side, which they're providing clients for you and they're paying you hourly, or if you want something where you are already providing your own clients or looking for your own clients. So there's different avenues for you to consider. So just to tell you a little bit about me and my story, I decided to become an esthetician after being in college and just being in and out of semesters and not being able to move forward. I finally got married and was pregnant, and I decided that I needed to go back to school and that I needed to make more than minimum wage. I was not done with school, so it was kind of like something that I wanted to do to make more money while I went back to school. But once being in the industry, I loved it, and I decided, you know, that this was for me, this was my passion, this was what I wanted to pursue and grow in, and I have been doing it for the past 10 years. So I started during school. I actually work for the counters. So I work for Clarins. I don't know if you're familiar, but here in the US, it is a brand in like Dillard's, or I don't know, Macy's carries them. So during school, I wasn't licensed yet, so I was hired. And then I was also a floater where I would be able to cover other brands. And I also, outside of that, I was working on my own. I decided I wanted to try an ML company. So ML company is a company that sells skincare. Anyone could sell it. And I figured I was becoming an esthetician. I want to sell skincare, but I didn't have access to professional lines yet. So I was doing that on my free time. I would sell the ML company and do facial parties and stuff like that. I graduated school. I knew that I would have the accessible to a professional line and to be working with professional lines that are going to be formulated different, more effective for the skin. So it's completely different lines. So I decided to leave the ML and the counter product, and I was going to focus on professional line. So after that, I was working at a spa in Miami, and I was doing facials and massage there. So I worked at a counter, I worked at MLL, and then at a spa. It was a really high-end spa resort, and I had transferred to a higher-end counter for Neiman Marcus. So if you are near Neiman Marcus and you like working counters, that is actually a really good paying store. At counter, I did make about $20, I want to say, an hour, or $25 an hour. So that was a really good opportunity for me. The only problem is that I felt a little empty, like I was just helping people choose their products, and in the spa it was also more relaxing, and I was really getting into helping people with their concerns, helping people with their problems. So, and I had that little bug of going on my own and thinking that that would be a good option for me. So I went on my own. I had a partner, and I decided to we partnered together, and we decided to open a spa salon. And I had that for about 1.5 years. Unfortunately, I went through some personal loss and some family problems. So I decided that it wasn't the best option for me at the time. I needed to invest a lot of time, a lot of energy, and there was other opportunities opening up for me to move to Texas. So I decided to leave the salon, and we sold it. They took over the lease, so it was kind of like a break even. Other than the products, we made back our money for that, and it was kind of like a break even. It was really hard. I think part of the reason that was really hard, it was because I was so new to the industry. So it was really hard, and I could make a separate video about that if you guys want to know more. You can leave a comment below. After that, I was focusing more on massage because, like I said, massage does pay more. So I wanted to save money so that we could make the move to Texas. I was working more on massage and nails because I also had my nail license. So unfortunately, at that time, opportunities were better in the massage and the nail. I was making about $30 an hour with massage and about that or more with nails too. So I had to put esthetician services on the side. When I moved to Texas, I started working with a counter kind of store. It was more independent owned stores, and it's Merrill Norman. So the only problem that I had there is that it was a lot more product based, and I missed, you know, the facials and the treatment side of it. So I started working at a spa in the city of West Laco, where I was trained to do laser, and I was really getting really into the actual services again. And that spa eventually closed down, and they were transferred ownership, so the new owner kept me on board. But then I got a really good opportunity to work at a med spa. And it was just a lot of services and lasers. So I was going to be doing pretty much everything that I really enjoyed to do. The only thing that was lacking there was that they didn't have products. So I kept ending up in places where either had only products, no services, or services and no products. And I was kept getting acne clients, I kept getting pigmentation, and I know, or if you're an esthetician watching this, you know that you just really need the help of the product to move that person through it. The services are going to be great to accelerate and to target deeper, but if you were using them together, you're exfoliating the skin, the products could penetrate deeper, you're really going to get really good results from both. Just so that you know in the future that it is best to have both of those available to you so that you could provide your clients with the best results. And when clients have really good results, they're just going to keep coming back and they're going to trust you. So I finally decided to go on my own. So I am now a solo esthetician again, just by myself. I rent a space and I do my services, which I love, and I have products available, so it's a perfect match. And I decided to do things a little bit different. The first time we went full salon and spa, and now I'm by myself. Maybe eventually I will grow back into a full service or a full space, but right now I'm by myself and I really enjoy it. So that is my story. I hope that this has been helpful for you and that it inspires you if you are considering, and that it answers a lot of your questions. If you have any questions, make sure that you leave them in the comments. Like this video so that other people could find it. YouTube will recommend it to people that are searching for this topic if the video is getting likes. And if you are still not an esthetician but like skincare, make sure that you subscribe, because that's what my channel is all about. Skincare services, products, and ingredients. So I really appreciate your time. Thank you so much for watching this video to the end, and find me on Instagram where you see the growth of my solo esthetician business.